Good day, dear students. Kindly get ready with your textbook. Okay. Now sit straight. Join your hands. Sit properly. Pray for 2 seconds. Yes. Now, what is our lesson's name? A game of chance. Okay. So this lesson is about chances. Okay. And what are we focusing on? We are focusing on a lucky shop, which is a stall in the fair related to Eid. Okay. So now let's see rest of the story. Then a boy a little older than I tried his luck. He got a comb worth 25 paise. The shopkeeper looked neither happy nor sad. He bought the comb from the boy for 25 paise. The boy tried his luck again. He now got a fountain pen worth 3 rupees. Then he tried a third time and got a wristwatch worth 25 rupees. When he tried again, he got a table lamp worth more than 10 rupees. The boy was happy and went away with a smile and a good deal of cash. So the boy had to give only 50 paise each time, but he received worthy gifts. Okay. Now we'll move on to the 7th paragraph. I wanted to try my luck too. I looked at Baya. He encouraged me. I paid 50 paise and took 6 discs. My luck was not too good. I got 2 pencils. The shopkeeper bought them from me for 25 paise. I tried again. This time I got a bottle of ink, also of little value. The shopkeeper bought that too for 25 paise. I took a chance for the third time. Still, luck was not with me. I had hopes of winning a prize and continued to try my luck again and again, paying 50 paise each time. But every time I got a trifle. What do you mean by trifle? Something which has less value. Okay. At last, I was left with only 25 paise. Again, the shopkeeper showed his kindness. He said I could either play once more with 25 paise or settle the account then and there. I played again and the last 25 paise also disappeared. People were looking at me. Some were laughing at my bad luck, but none showed any sympathy. Baya and I went to the place where Uncle had left us and waited for him to return. Presently, he came. He looked at me and said, "Rashid, you look upset. What is the matter?" I did not say anything. Baya told him what had happened. Uncle was neither angry nor sad. He smiled and patted me. He took me to a shop and bought me a beautiful umbrella, biscuits and sweets, and some other little gifts. Then we returned home. Back home, Uncle told me that the lucky shop man had made a fool of me. No, uncle, I said, it was just my bad luck. No, my boy, said uncle, it was neither good luck nor bad luck. But uncle said, I saw an old man getting a clock and a boy getting two or three costly things. You don't know, child, uncle said. They were all friends of the shopkeeper. They were playing tricks to tempt you to try your luck. They wanted your money and they got it. Now forget about it and don't tell anybody of your bad luck or your foolishness. So the boy thought that he did not have any luck. But what actually happened is the shopkeeper was playing tricks on him, because people who came to his shops were his friends. So a poor boy got tricked. Okay, isn't it a good chapter? Yes. So in this chapter, what is the message you are getting? Don't believe if someone tells you that you are not lucky. Please don't believe it. Okay, because you know you are worth, you are lucky, you are so special. So please don't believe to the words said by others. All right, now read your chapter at least thrice. Okay? Yes.